I observe, acknowledge the presence of the Chief Librarian and the President. May I just say all protocols observed and got free and meet. So there are two things that I'm going to talk about before I begin my presentation. The first one is that it's very difficult to speak after the President has spoken. Because whatever I wanted to say, the President said. So all I would do maybe is to ask you to clap for me. Because my presentation has already been done. So the struggle, I had to remain over lunch just to prepare another presentation because we were together in spirit with the President. So presenting after lunch is one of the most difficult times I've had to face. Let's hope no one will be praying here. Please let us see. Let us not consult our ancestors as we look. So we want to look at customer care and the marketing of library services, not only in Zambia, but generally, okay? And when we talk about our customers or clients, we are not only looking at adults. Because we have seen, we have children's library, not so. So when we talk about clients, we are incorporating everybody from zero, like the MC said, to 99. Even those that are beyond if they are able to receive our services. So we just need to share. My presentation will be very much interactive so that we learn from each other. Let's just do like a small exercise. Let's do this. But I don't mean your PF, it's just okay, with power, right? Okay, so you say one. Okay. Plus.
Plus.
Another one.
One.
Equals.
Equals.
With the power. Two.
Two.
Correct. Okay, let's do two.
Two.
Plus.
Plus.
Another two.
Two.
Equals.
Equals.
Four. Let's do a four. Okay. For the last one, let's do four.
Four.
Plus.
Plus.
Another four.
Another four.
Equals
80.
Now she's dancing. I think. <Again. laughs> So we have children, we have adults, we are serving as our clients. And when you're dealing with adults, it's one thing. When you're dealing with children, the level of customer care must actually be above board because there are issues of frustrations there if you're not careful. So we want to look at all that. Okay. So I have few important questions I need to ask you. How would you describe a welcoming library? That is question number one. Question number two. What is your library and its staff? What is your library and its staff already doing? You tell me, you describe to me a welcoming library, and you tell me what your library and the staff are doing, then what could your library be doing better or different? I need honest answers. So question number one, how would you describe a welcoming library? Because remember, we are dealing with clients who may not be willing to visit our library. And if nobody visits our library, then we would consider it a mob, right? What are we going to do to attract them to come? The reading culture has already been talked about. People are not willing to come and read. And you are a librarian who has been employed there. What are you going to do if people are not coming? And if people are coming, what would you describe a welcoming library? What is it like? Sorry, like my president, I'm also a teacher, so. Yes, madam.
I think if people are not coming to the library, I think maybe you can come up with a strategy. You create an event or an activity that will be happening on the premises of the library. Then you invite people to come. Then from there, you try to explain what is happening at the library. Then people will be attracted then.
So in short, you are saying a welcoming library should have activities that would invite people.
Yes.
Okay? Are we all agreeing with your answer?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maybe I'll put it, a welcoming library is one which meets the needs of the people or the community at large.
Okay. The one that meets the needs of the community. Okay, let me pick two more answers before we... Yeah, okay, yes?
I think if we should meet the needs of the user, it's important to give a friendly reception to whoever is visiting your library. Of course, first impression is very important to anybody who comes, even in our homes. If the visitor comes and they're not happy, it will show no face. And they'll never have like... So the reception is very important with anyone, whoever, because you don't know what's going on. So you just have to give a very good reception
to the party. Okay, one more? Yes?
For me, maybe I can say environmental friendly, like the library should be clean, well organized, and the receptionist should be friendly.
Okay. All right. What is your library and its staff already doing? Are you what you are describing? Or that is where you are intending to be?
We are already there.
We are already there. Then why are we here?
That's the thing.
We are not there.
We are not there.
We can do better.
We can do better. Correct. Okay. So what could your library be doing better or differently? Better than what you are doing now. Okay, so the answers that you have given, I was actually learning from you because I'm not a librarian, by the way. So I'm happy I've learned what a welcoming library should be like. Okay, I've got some answers from there. Now let's see. Get back to our business. What is customer service? How would you define customer service or customer care, as others like putting it? What is customer care? Has customer care got anything to do with how you talk to your clients, how you respond to calls? Has it got anything to do with how you dress as a librarian? So different authors have actually given various definitions in as far as customer care is concerned. But whatever the differences, you realize that the technique behind each definition is almost the same. Okay? So we are saying we are dealing with clients. Our customer service level may be disturbed a bit because we are non-profit making. Those that are in profit making even exaggerate their level of customer service so that they can excite the customer. But how do we exaggerate the level of our customer care so that we can excite those people we need to save? Because there's a problem with librarians. Because most of you are not outgoing. I don't know how or why. Most librarians are not outgoing. They are quiet people. I don't know, maybe it's the role of staying with the books in the library when you try not talking to them and so on. You would find that they are in their own world. Okay? But you cannot offer proper customer care if you are not outgoing. You can't be a librarian who doesn't want to talk. So I want to tell you that this profession is not a profession for the faint-hearted. If you decided to be a librarian because you thought, I'm here, I'm quiet. Let me see, maybe there's anyone who is quiet. No, I'm quiet. I don't want to talk from... I disapprove it. Okay? So So this is not a profession for those that think they are quiet. If you think you are quiet, you don't want to talk, you can still tell us so that we tell you the best profession to take. Maybe you do accounts where you're alone in a closed door, in a closed gate. But even accountants would need to explain their books of accounts, not so. So we interact with people every day, would need to talk. Okay? Now, that is just a picture depicting customer care. So I want you to define customer service using this picture. Some of the things that we do are not even related to our jobs. They are not related to what we are doing. You are busy on phone. Somebody is waiting, and with pride you are even asking, so, and it's, you see, it's not even work related. And then after discussing for 10 minutes, you say, oh, let me talk to a client. Sorry, I have a client. Anyway, just call me after 5 minutes. The client. How do you know that the client will be there for 5 minutes or 10? In short, you are telling them, look, I'm in a hurry. I need to get back on my phone. Tell me what you want to tell me quickly before I go. There are things we call small things in customer care, but they really matter. We say small things matter. If you don't believe me, try sleep with a mosquito in a room. You will see how it will tell. A small thing. So those things we think are small actually bring our institutions down. Just a phone call. Remember, you are not making profits. And when these people come, sometimes they even push themselves. You didn't even advertise to tell you people come, we are here. They come. Customer. A customer is anyone who requests assistance. Now, we want to talk about a customer. Then from this, we are going to know what customer service is. So I'm saying a customer is anyone who requests for assistance. Information. The library you're working for is the only library you have. But they have so many choices. They can choose to go to other libraries and so on. And if you are going to have a library where you don't have clients and so on, and you are told to write reports, what are you going to write about? So you become unethical, start lying now. No, we have 20,000 visits and so on. Writing the names yourselves on the visitor's book and changing the handwriting and so on. But it doesn't help you in any way. Okay? So we must have an art of assisting people who need information from us. That is the reason why we are here. Sometimes we get pissed if somebody asks too many questions. All we have to do is point. You see, we have all those hours there. Just go and check. But what are you doing? You get irritated for what you should be doing. Is that fair to our clients?
No.
Like the president said, it's not a question. See, there are so many workshops you have attended on customer service, but the question is, at what level are you now? Or is it because you only need a certificate of attendance so that your CV can be big? Because it is not about a CV. When we are attending workshops like this, talking about customer care, we are interested in the attitude. Because look, these certificates, I don't even like them. They are just there to confirm that this is what you did. What we need is an attitude. But what attitude do you have towards your clients? Because for this certificate, have you ever heard of material? Mm-hmm. These can be forged. Anyone can forge. And they can have it. But nobody will ever forge an attitude. And that is what we need. Every other workshop should be a workshop to make us grow intellectually and so on. Like they said, from this workshop, you are still the same. The next workshop, you even become worse. There are people who have gone to school, did their masters, others are doing their degrees and so on, but the levels of customer care are becoming pathetic. After getting the degree now, they can't even talk to clients. No, I'm studying. I'm actually looking at my thesis for my PhD. Can you talk to those guys there? But we hope that after doing school, your customer care can do what? So we need to provide information. Let us assist people, because you are the one who knows. I don't even know the cataloging. These are the names just that I know. Cataloging and whatever, whatnot. But you have to assist us. Because I'm speaking from the point of knowledge, because I'm your client, by the way. I use libraries. And I meet a lot of personalities. Some of them wouldn't even want to talk to a client if there are two of them. They say, hey, with these translucent libraries, have you seen that man coming there? I don't want to deal with him. Please take charge, Ngalaya, I'll come back. Now, assuming that person comes when you are alone, what are you going to do? I have witnessed an incident where a librarian was in a was literally shouting at a client. I know my job, you do not employ me. This is a serious. I said to myself, I thought I had a camera, I would have just get like a video or whatever it is, so I can just be using that for a presentation. Now, you know, you see, it doesn't need the, you know, sometimes people even tell you who they are. But we don't need the fools to be librarians. But we didn't know you were one. Why did you join this profession? Because this is a noble profession. Okay? This is a noble profession which needs people who have the heart for their clients. Because if you didn't know, librarians are like pastors. Even with so many mistakes, you tell people, look, those books are not supposed to be there. When you get a book, don't push it back on the aisle. Just put it where you find after reading somebody's stashing the book there and so on. You have to be patient with them. That is your calling. If you can't afford to do that, then please, this is not your profession. Leave it for others who can manage. I don't know if you're getting what I'm talking about. So this one is very much critical. But on this one, I was not involved. So what we are saying is that let us not have multiple images. Because once you have been found in a situation that is wanting, it is not only your name that is going to be brought into review, but what? The whole institution. Okay. And your name, what these generals do, your name comes last. They will say, Lubuto Library Association's country coordinator, then your name comes at the end, court committing iniquity. And the whole institution is brought into the group. So let us have images that are going to help us perform in our duties. We can be moving with header. You go to Livingstone, you're someone else. You go there, they know you're a rebel. But you don't know that there are people who come from far-flung places who have visited your library, you don't even know. So let us make sure that as we save our clients, we save them with integrity. Regardless. There could be our internal customers, there could be external customers, but we just need to save them. Okay? I think I've explained on internal customer care. Any individual department or section unit which requests information from you, you're going to give them. Okay? It could be an individual, a unit, and so on, provide information. Because you are an expert in that field, you know. Don't be intimidated by people who come. They could be doctors, they could be what, but you are. You are an expert in that field. So provide information. Okay? Provide information so that you don't deprive of your clients the most needed information. Okay? Right? So we have staff as one another service providers, just a continuation. Staff at various levels need to give instructions, seek and give each other instruction or advice. Make and implement policies on how to best serve customers. But if you are not going to work well with your clients, how are you going to come up with plans? If you're not going to work well with your internal clients, how are you going to make and implement policies? Because these policies cannot be implemented together. Okay? They need the efforts of everybody. Because you can be there as a chief librarian or a librarian, but you need the services of these others. You need the services of cleaners. Okay, to talk about the cleanness you talked about. But if you are not in good boots with the cleaners and so on, every time when there's something wrong, it's you to complain. No, these people have given me. But why all the time you alone complaining? Then you know that there's a problem. You just have to learn customer care. It's an art. You have to improve on it. Because there are people who have hot tempers. Extremely hot tempers. Let us make sure that we are there to provide a service. If you have issues from home, leave them at home. Somebody asks a question twice because you have been provoked at home by the husband, by the wife. Or what comes, after all, your friend has provoked me also. Which friend of mine? Me and my client. I've come to receive a service. So why are you saying my friend provoked you? So when you are, if you are not in the right mood, so to say, better don't go for it. Than denting the image of the entire institution because of you not being good at that particular day. It's not good. If you are able to develop good customer care skills, it will lead you to have what? To have what? The reason why we don't have good customer care most of the times is because of bad attitude towards you. Somebody sent me a WhatsApp message which I was looking for. I wanted to beam it here, but I couldn't find it. Maybe I deleted. I don't know. Maybe most of you received that. Where they said, love is nothing, because if we are going to count one up to the last word, the last letter of the alphabetical order, in the alphabet, if this is going to be 1, B, 2, C, and so on up the last one, love doesn't even make 100%. You can love or you care your clients, but that doesn't change anything. Maybe it's about 60% or so. Who has ever received that? You did that? Who hasn't received that?
I received, but I didn't read it.
Yeah? Uncle, reading couch. Okay. Now, I like that concept because it emphasized the importance of good attitude. I don't know if you're getting it. Just change that. If you can't change it, then you're going nowhere. And we are not going to say, please let us see those that have a bad attitude. If there is one in this room, quietly repent. Yeah? Because look, we can't go anywhere with a bad attitude. Because our customer service is a combination of a lot of things. We need to perfect our art. We need to perfect our art. If you can have an attitude, there's no need to have. That is why in certain institutions, people come with their masters, their degrees, that they are promoting Mr. Mlenga, because Mr. Mlenga has been working there for a long time. Why? Because of the attitude. No, but what about the papers? This one, Mdimbari of Senegal. There's no Senegal there. It's just a pure attitude. And people are saying, this is what we need. Are we going to be saving people the papers?
No.
We're not going to be saving people the papers. We need an attitude, and this attitude must be changed if it is not a good one. No negotiations. We can't negotiate. Have you ever had a tire burst? Or just a tire getting flat, you're on the road? Can you go anywhere?
No.
You just have to park. So if you have that attitude, I'm sorry. We can't mind you resigning. Can't mind you, because you are denting our profession. We don't need people to be talking about, hey, librarians, librarians, just because of one librarian who gave them headache. No? So what is attitude? The way you feel, the way you think, and what you believe about something or someone. Please have a positive attitude. How you feel should be positive. How you think should be positive. What you believe in about something or someone should be positive. And you just have to tell yourself, say, look, this is what we're doing. If you have a positive direction towards life, nothing will be very difficult. Let us have the spirit of winning in whatever we are doing. Okay? So your attitude will always determine what you do and how you behave at work. They don't need another workshop. You are a workshop yourself. You become a trainer of trainers. Because you are late. Very important, okay? So the biggest disability of a person in life is bad and negative attitude. Don't think people don't see a disabled. If you have an attitude, a negative attitude, you are always a negative person. So let us make sure that we change what we do. We are talking about people now, because they can't employ you without papers. You should have gone to the University of Zambia or to Evening Horn and so on for the paper. So if you want to perform, you can have qualifications, you can have experience, you can have the right attitude. But for excellent performance, because here we are looking at excellent performance, you need 80% attitude, which is positive, 20% skills. You have the right skills, the right knowledge, right qualifications. So qualification, experience, and so on comes in the what? 20%, but 80% should be the attitude. Have the positive attitude, then you are done. You can have all these qualifications here, but if your attitude is not there, you are dead meat. There is nothing that you can do. So, attitude is very much important. It's more than the qualification. And we really need that. One professor mentioned in the workshop that if we can have the change of attitude in the civil service, we have one professor of public administration, Professor Takat from South Africa, said if the attitude can change, then there if attitude in the civil service can change, then we can have some increase in GDP of 2%. The gross domestic product of 2% is seeing one, it's a huge figure just because of the attitude. Certain people have wonderful, like your student, madam. I've spoken to her. I said, look, you are an example of what a librarian should be. She comes late, okay? Though we say she was delayed, you know, traffic in Lusaka. She gets delayed, she comes and she finds a queue. People are waiting. The other colleague just came. You know, with youth, ladies. And people are there waiting for the library. The library should have been open at 9 o'clock. It is 10, it's not open. And people are desperate, you know, when they're about to write an exam. She not without even talking to anybody. Co opens car, goes car, and the people were commenting. She can't even say so. In no time, your student came. She was there. Good morning. We are very sorry we have been delayed. You know this traffic in Lusaka. I'm telling you. Do you have anybody who has a helicopter here? Making fun out of the situation. Please, if anybody has a helicopter, I'm just going to say, we are very much sorry. Please, just give me under 1 minute. I'm coming. Let me just prepare myself. Then she rushes and everybody, the mood changes and so on. That's how it's supposed to be. Okay. Not as if you are the one who crucified Christ every time your attitude is. What is the problem? Some people can't even smile at their clients. A client comes, what do you want? Oh, okay. Yes, yes, no. You know, you answering in shortcuts. Leading in the side, we are talking about SADC region here. Not just in Lusaka, SADC. So when we begin strategizing, our competition is not in Lusaka. We can't compete against the University of Zambia. No, that's not our competition. We are looking at, bring the University of Cape Town, we can start talking now. Because we are looking at the SADC region. But how are you going to be the best, depending on the vision? If you go to class, desks, we don't have even desks. You go to classes of teaching, you are just there waffling and so on. If you understand your vision, you go to class, you make sure. Because you are saying you want to be the best by 2030. If we want to construct a library, we are not going to play at it. Because we are saying in 2030 we want to be the best. That's the reason why we have that capital city there, within NIP. But what is your vision? Does your vision drive you every morning to go for work? Maybe let me understand the vision for the association.
What's our vision, people?
Those that can manage to read, please. Shall we don't have poor reading count. What is the vision for the association?
An association promoting excellence and innovation in the provision of library services.
An association promoting what? Excellence. And I want to believe that individual libraries are drawing their visions from the main vision. Are you going to provide excellency with bad attitude?
No.
Because what makes the association is a combination of you people from different libraries. So excellence comes because you people know the reason why you are here. You can't provide excellence with bad attitude. So you begin from there. Right? Aspects of attitude. A positive attitude supports work performance and working relations that are required to get one work done efficiently. No. When I go there, I just find my buddies. Oh, you come, pangika, so una pangika, yeah. You are there.
Let me see.
Hey, I'm not family, you know. You see, it's just about attitude. I told myself I don't want to suffer in my life. And I'll never do that. If somebody tells you you will suffer, you say when? Okay. Although we don't say no, it's not by pronouncement, but it's about what you do. If you are willing to become a better person, you are going to be a better person. Even when there are people who have been working there and so on, if your attitude is good, people will monitor attitude and say, ah, I think from this, let us give this one. This one, let us give this one. Then people say, okay, it's a job, maybe. There's nothing, there is no juju in prosperity. Yeah. Remember that? Senegal lost there. For example, they lost. You see, I think they believe that Zambia is a Christian nation. Yeah, so these people say the truth. In South Africa, they managed because they have sangomas also, and their sangomas were greater, so they couldn't do it. So, attitude towards self is very much important. Attitude towards others, please, this is very important. Mm-hmm. Other people are a reason why you are existing if you didn't know. Mm-hmm. You can't live in this world alone. You can't. You can even die in 1 hour. You look around, there's nobody. You look around, you try to shout, you run, there's no one. You are just alone. You can find yourself hanging there. And you look for a rope, there's no rope to hang yourself. You just collapse dead. So attitude towards others is very, this is the most important thing. If you don't have regard for others, then you are not a human being. Don't underrate other people in whatever you are doing. Because life is a network. People are talking about networking here. Life is a network. Respect each person you find. Because you don't know what they are going to do in the future. Some of you are failing to go far because of lack of respect for other people. You don't recognize this one is the president, don't recognize there's a chief there. Ah, my member, you see, we don't behave like that because we need each other. You see, when I completed my great work, I worked for Trade Kings briefly. I was fired at Trade Kings, okay? It's just to say, you know, I'm a young boy. So that I'm eating well, that's why. I completed in 1999, so you can get clear, you know, that I'm actually young. So after completing, I worked briefly for Trade King, but I was fired by my boss. For petty reasons, you know. I caught them petty because I was told, no, I went to complain to the director, why are you not employing me permanently? I was getting paid one a week, I worked for 1 year plus. Said, but how long, boss? Then the director said, you, it's not possible. You're not Trade Kings to be employed. 300. But others were employed, I was not employed. I go to complain, the director said, it's not possible because for the past 3 months, we employed 600 people when they opened their sweets plant. I was in pest. We employed 600, and you're saying you have been working for almost a year. It's not possible. Let me call your boss. My boss was called. He said, no, this man doesn't want you to work. He goes to school after work. I don't know what he was thinking about. At 17, after knocking off, this person went. Then I was told, no, your boss said you're not serious with work, you go to school. I said, but boss, I go to school after work. He said, no, there's nothing that I can do because your boss has fired you. I tried to cry. My boss told me, I just get out. I was going to die in those chemicals. Those are... Even up to now, from 1999, I feel as if there's something here in my nose. I have the tendency of doing because of that chemical. Third part, I would have died there. We are now friends. I told him to say, attitude is very much towards others. What is your attitude towards your colleagues? What is your attitude towards your clients? The people you deal with. Because you never know when people are coming. We have ministers who are studying. Some of them you don't even know, especially these days. We have youth ministers, you can't even know. When you go to parliament, you can even bump into them. Very youthful. They will come casually dressed and so on. They don't want to be noticed that they're doing what? They are studying. How do you? I don't know. Me, I just joined. So what? The customer doesn't know that you just joined. Just to provide the necessary answers. If you don't know, there's no harm in saying, excuse me, let me just consult my colleague. Don't say, I don't know, then you go. Provide an option for a client. Because customers will come with inquiries. That's the reason why you are there, the inquiry desk there and so on. Listen actively to our customers. We have a tendency of not listening. We are in a hurry. Where do we rush to? No, I have a question. Somebody has a question and you are standing up, huh? Giving a signal that you want to go. So you, yes, yes, yes. Now you are giving somebody an impression that you don't want to talk to them. Know the programs, know the rules and activities of your organization. Okay. Warning. Difficult clients ahead. Some clients have a problem. I don't know what to do. I would rather resign than. Why then are you looking at customer service? How do you deal with difficult customers? Identify causes of difficulty. We told you there are only two rules. The client is always what? Right. Rule number one. Rule number two. If you don't understand rule number one, read it again. Identify causes of difficulty, which could be mistakes in our effort to save customers. Because sometimes, you know, we like pushing the blame. Sometimes it's us making. Not moment material in the age. I'm talking sometimes in the age. Let us stay calm and not answer back. Let us give. How much do you have? We have nothing indeed. What is your problem? Try to do the marketing by showing them to say this is what you have done yourselves. And this is what we are. Sometimes you can even do a strategy. Say, this is what we have. When you have nothing, you are hoping to have. But this is what we have and we need this. And you know when that comes and plus what you are going to get, things are going to move. Okay, then you have a stronger, just... What is the, yes, I'm just...